Direct Color Systems' Color Byte software has many powerful tools that give you the edge when it comes to providing custom products to your customers. The tool we are looking at today is the badge layout option. I've created a name badge in the software for my favorite restaurant, Star Burgers. I will now create a group of badges that include employee names and titles. After typing in my text, I highlight it and notice the options across the top toolbar. One of these is kerneling. 102 or 103 is best for most applications, but you can adjust it as desired. Notice that a lower number gives you less space between individual letters. The next setting I'll look at is the line properties. I have chosen absolute length. This means that whatever name I provide, it will be forced to fit in the same amount of space that I initially designated when I created the text box. I have created a hairline outline around my badge for ease during the design process. It is important that when I'm designing, I check that all of my elements fit inside the box. When I'm ready to proceed, I remove the outline. I then highlight my entire badge and go to Layout, Badges. Note the preview at the bottom left corner. It tells me how many badges I can fit on my blank. If you don't see the preview, be sure that the Use Plate box is unchecked. Mine will fit 27, but you can choose to print as many as you want. Additional badges will be printed on a second blank. Now, I highlight the text that I want to be changed when I create my badges. There are two options when entering data. You can import a file, or you can type it in on the fly. When you use this dialog box, however, your data isn't saved. Therefore, if you click OK and then notice a typo, you'll have to type everything over again. It's better to use the import option. I choose a text file that I have previously created. Each line of my text file represents a new badge. A comma separates the employee name and title. I have a number of options when choosing my separator. In many cases, the comma is the best choice. But here, in an alternate file, you see that the person's name contains a comma. In this case, it's necessary to choose a different separator. I can see now that all of my data has been imported correctly. So I click OK and see that Color Byte has filled the blank with badges. At this point, I can simply go to File, Print and Cut, and begin printing my badges. The badge layout function isn't just for name badges, though. I'll open a new file and show you another possible application. Here, I've created a blank so that I can print metallic serial number plates. I'm using the same methods that I used in creating my restaurant name badges. Again, I go to Layout, Badges. I select My Serial Number for replacement, and this time I unclick the replacement data file and click OK. You can create a file that has serial numbers in it, similar to the name badge file, but often it's easier to let Color Byte do the work for you. I type in the first serial number, highlight the column, and click Serialization. In this dialog box, I only need to choose how many I want to increment by, and whether I want to increase the alpha or numeric part of the serial number. Then I click OK, and OK again, and all of my badges are created for me. For more information, please see our other videos on YouTube or check out our website, directcolorsystems.com.